Recently incarcerated DJ Tommy Lee Sparta debuts at number 2 on the US iTunes reggae charts for the first time. The artist landed on the charts with his crossover Spanish-influenced track, Elegante, featuring Mexican Ja Fabio and Jamaican newcomer Cashin.
Never yet him say I'm sorry. Never hear girls say I'm boring. Rich badness for the glory. Let the story tell the story.
The song is produced by Contractor Music and a collaboration with Danger Zone Music and Boss Lady Music. Boss Lady says she's proud of the track.
We're very excited that Tommy is emerging the Latin American reggaeton market.
And we certainly look forward to doing more crossover projects in the future.
We're gearing up for the release of his next album in the next few months, which we will share more information as the time gets closer to the release date.
Tommy Lee Sparta was recently sentenced to 3 years in jail after pleading guilty to illegal possession of a firearm and ammunition. Ramesh Shah of Ramesh Entertainment, designer and manager of Shensia, TJ and Ding Dong, has moved to help the less fortunate with food packages during the lockdown. The businessman, based on the announced lockdown, saw where he could help and got busy with his team to package and distribute food items for near to 300 families last weekend. His charitable venture continues this Easter weekend, where he says he is expected to feed 500 more. The businessman, who started from his own pocket, has been getting support from corporate Jamaica and financial donations coming from all over the world. Justin Bieber's album Justice debuted at number 1 on the Billboard 200 chart. His single Peaches, featuring Daniel Caesar and Givian, also debuted at number 1 on the Billboard Hot 100. According to Billboard, it makes him the first solo male artist to debut at the top of both charts simultaneously. But as the 27-year-old singer celebrates, he's also responding to critics who questioned his use of Martin Luther King Jr.'s speech on his album. Justin broke his silence in an interview with Clubhouse, where he explained that his ignorance to Black history made him a part of the problem.
I mean, they didn't teach us about Black history, and that was just not a part of our education system. And like, I think for me, coming from Canada and, you know, being uneducated and, you know, making insensitive jokes when I was a kid and being insensitive and being honestly just a part of the problem, because I was just, I just didn't know better. I was willing to, you know, go through as much hate by putting that on the album, just because I know that there's a bigger purpose. And I'm not trying to be, you know, the white savior, and that's just not my heart. My heart is just to amplify Martin Luther King's voice.
The daughter of Martin Luther King Jr., Bernice King, took to Twitter, where she thanked Justin, tweeting, "Each of us, including artists and entertainers, can do something." Similar, of course, to the recent messages here in Jamaica. I'm Deidran, reporting for E-Prime.